I got my gangsta guy here, yo. What up, cuz? Break yourself, break yourself, break yourself, cuz.
This is a ghost gun. This right here has ability with a 30 caliber clip to disperse with 30 bullets within half a second. 30 magazine clip in half a second.
We have federal regulations and state laws that prohibit hunting ducks with more than 3 rounds. And yet, it's legal to hunt humans.
Say hello to my little friend!
Australia just said, well, that's it. We're not seeing that again. And imposed very severe, tough gun laws, and they haven't had a mass shooting since.
But you know, semi-automatic weapons are not just about gun control. This is about national security. You know that these weapons can shoot down airplanes.
Break yourself! Break yourself! Break yourself!
Assault rifle and a hunting rifle is, frankly, the scope that one puts on it, and scopes can be purchased online.
Okay, I want to see people disarmed. Permits, they actually
I want
to,
people disarmed in our major cities. How's that for a plan?
We cannot let a minority of people hold a viewpoint that terrorizes the majority of people.
Could have been done on spur of the moment with a hunting rifle very easily, as long as it was a double-shot weapon. They can easily do it with something that you can purchase at a grocery store.
Say hello to my little friend!
I think the Second Amendment is in the Constitution so that we can have muskets when the British people come over in 1800.
I know what you're thinking. Did he fire 6 shots or only 5? You've got to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Frick yourself! Cuz...
tired of those guns that don't shoot themselves? Do you wish you, too, had one of those guns that shoots 30 clips a second? How about a gun with a bullet button that will convert your single-shot bolt-action rifle to an automatic assault weapon? Well, have we got the gun for you? You've heard all those politicians talking about this gun, but you didn't think it was real, right? Well, it's real. It's called the Super Duper Crap It's Real Gun. That's right, the Super Duper Crap It's Real Gun. And now, you can buy this gun for only $5 by just calling this number, 1-800-GET-A-GUN. That's 1-800-GET-A-GUN. Just give us an address and pay COD when we deliver it. The Super Duper Crap It's Real Gun. Finally, an automatic assault weapon that will mow down your neighbors all by itself.
Brought to you by the makers of Invisible Passports, the indestructible passport for the savvy terrorist that wants to make sure people remember him after he's gone. This gun may not be available in any of the 50 states or in any of the countries that exist on the planet today. If you do actually call 1-800-GET-A-GUN, you might not actually get through to an operator that's actually selling the Super Duper Crap It's Real Gun. This is a parody commercial intended to trigger the jimmies of your gun-phobic, state-worshipping friends.
Be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe to Full Auto across our network. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/Full Auto Show. On Spreaker, you can find us at spreaker.com/show/Full Auto. We post our latest episodes on YouTube at youtube.com/C/State of Wake Show. And if you want to write to us, you can email us at show@fullautoshow.com. For all of the links and latest news on our show, go to our website at fullautoshow.com.
So, Mr. Dimitri, you like to talk big game. You talk big game about guns. What you know about Trump gun? You tell us everything. Go ahead.
We have ways of making you talk.
No, we said that to you. You don't say that to us. You are the one being interrogated, Mr. Dimitri, with your big fat mouth, your big fat Greek mouth.
Wait.
Big fat Greek mouth.
My name is Eastern European, too.
Right. Yes, your name is Eastern. You know what we did to Eastern Europe. We do that to you now. You shut your big fat Greek mouth. You know nothing about the Tokarev. Nothing to see here.
That's true. I know very little about the Tokarev.
And you know nothing about Trump's guns. Don't be talking about Trump's gun anymore.
Well, Trump doesn't need guns. He's got the Secret Service in his own.
Oh, but security. He's insisting on carrying his own gun.
Well, good for him.
That's what I say. And like I saw a poll. It's asking conservatives, and I mean, there's a conservatives, libertarians, basically a bunch of pro-gun people, whether they're conservative, libertarian, the whole group, and they're asking them, "Do you think that President Trump should be allowed to carry a gun as a president?" Seriously, if suddenly I woke up and they said, "Mr. Collier, you are now the president of the United States of America, but you can't carry," in principle, even though I don't carry because I don't have guns because of the boating accident, I would probably say no.
Yeah, I'm good.
I'd be like, no, man. I mean, really, if you're going to be president of the United States, That would be, you're applying for a concealed carry license. Oh, yeah. Yeah, people want to kill me.
Yeah. You're filling out the application. What is the purpose of you wanting a concealed carry permit? Recreational shooting, target shooting, self-defense. And you're going down the list. Yeah, people want to kill me.
People want to kill me. Probably about at least 500 million. At least 500 million people want to kill me.
The ones that voted illegally you're talking about, right?
No, I'm talking about worldwide because it's not just Americans that want to kill
me. 500 million. I thought you meant 5 million.
Oh, no, no.
500 that voted illegally.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Well, they definitely.
Voting is a crime anyway, so. Yeah. And we're just going to go ahead and gloss on over that. We were talking about, actually, before we get to the Tokarev, I want to do a little notations here. We are not on Spreaker. We are a video show now. We've decided to switch over to video. Well, I have decided to switch over to video because whenever I ask Dimitri, "Hey, Dimitri, what do you think we are do this?" They're like, "Yeah, okay, yeah." Because he's like a little lady. He's like
just
a little lady.
Do the freaking show.
Right, he's like a little, you know, I call him, I'm like, "Yo, Dimitri, you know, we go out to eat. Where you want to eat?" And he's like, "Hey, wherever you want." because that's Dimitri, who he is.
What do you think of this, Dimitri?
And Dimitri's like, yeah, yeah, whatever.
Okay, we're going to do the short. Yeah. We're going to do the show in five parts. We're going to do this part, this part, this part, this part, and this part. And like a week from now, we're going to only do it in four parts.
But, and oh, wait, no, and then five
we're
again.
We're going to do one part, but we're going to break it up into five parts.
Yeah.
But what do you think?
Right. We're going to have 18 bumps, 18 music.
Here, we're going to run the commercials in between the bumps, but we're going to backfeed it. What does that mean? I don't care. Just
you know,
do
don't, yes, yeah, yeah, yeah. Sure. We got to watch the radio backdraft, but we could do this, you know.
All right, no, we're going to structure it for a radio program. Okay, that's fine. Just do the show. No, I'm done with the radio format.
Right.
It's a death.
Actually,
it's a death.
I am. I'm done with the radio format.
I'm telling people exactly what
this
happens.
Is true story. This is what happens.
Okay. So can we just do the radio show? Wait, I have technical glitches that I have to get over.
That part you can't help. That's just the way it is.
It's just do the show.
You just, can't just do
okay,
the show.
We're do,
you got to
do
it right.
We're going to do a halftime, right? I'm like, I don't care. It's just... do the show.
I have to find another monkey. This one's broken.
You do.
This one's
because I'm
broken.
Done throwing shit.
This
I'm
one done. Is this monkey is totally broken. Definitely need a new monkey. So we have switched over. Right now we are live streaming. If you're listening to this live, we're live streaming on the Liberty Principle, No Cassette from the Governed Facebook page. So,
wait, is there anything like dead streaming? And if so, what does that mean?
I think that dead streaming is actually there have been a few dead streams. There was somebody who was live streaming and then they died and they lay on the floor for like 3 or 4 hours while it was still, I guess at that point it was dead streaming. And there were jokes because that's what you do on Facebook. When somebody dies on a live stream, you make jokes about dead streaming. That's what you do. And there were memes. Of course, there had to be memes because, yeah, that's what you do. But anyway, you can go to Facebook and look up the – if you just look up the Liberty Principle, you'll probably find it. And we air on there Tuesday nights at 6 p.m. God's time. Which is Eastern Standard Time, as all of you know, I'm sure. All of you listening, even if you're listening in England, you said right away, oh, God's time, I know that. It's Eastern Standard Time. You would be correct.
What about God's calendar?
God's calendar is probably the lunar calendar, because that's what the Jewish festivals and feast days and all that stuff are set to, right? Mm-hmm. But that opens up a whole other can of worms for all you people that are...
Yeah, not a conversation for gun talk.
Probably not. You did this. You did this. You brought in the God calendar thing. By the way, if anyone out there is listening that happens to be a monkey with a modicum of knowledge of guns, please write me at paul@fullautoshow.com. And I will accept applications to replace this broken monkey.
I will be very happy.
Look at that monkey. Look at that monkey.
Any applications. And
I'm so glad we have the visuals so they can see what a monkey you are. That's awesome.
I would love for someone to replace me as soon as possible.
As soon as possible.
Send those applications in lickety split.
Yes. You must be able to work with a lot of changes.
Yeah, you should.
Every week. You know, this is the format of the show. Never mind. This is the format of the show.
We're going for the radio audience. Maybe not. No.
I was actually I was hardcore into, you know, let's try to get this show on radio, and I've been researching and I was like, man, I don't know. I'm not going to be like the Buggles back in 1979 is actually when it came out, but I think it really didn't become known until 82. Video killed the radio star, and then, you know, the radio star is still here, but
I get the feeling we're boring people.
No! People are like, right now, they're messaging us. They're like, dude, keep it up. This show is awesome. This is the best show ever. Now they're
sleepy.
Are you getting sleepy? Yeah. Are you getting tired? You want to move into Tokarov talk? You want to talk about the what have you discovered so far in your...
I haven't discovered very much. All I know is, wow, that's an impressive round.
Yeah, I stumbled upon it, actually, because it was one of those suggested videos. Actually, no, I know how I stumbled upon it. I stumbled upon it by making a mistake.
Oh, a happy accident?
A happy accident. Remember I was telling you about the 7.62 by 2.5, but that actually was not the round I was thinking of. It was the... Was that the 5.7 something by 2.8?
Yeah, 7.5 or the 5.7.
5.7 yeah. Something by 2.8. Okay, so, it's in an FN gun.
Correct.
And it looks really cool. It looks like a little 5.56 cartridge in your handgun, and it looks really cool. But I saw a test for it where it was competing with a 9mm, and the 9mm kicked its butt in that non-scientific test. And it was the non-scientific test was the guy was shooting the plates that pivot
steel
around.
Plates?
Yeah. And the 9mm was knocking them back and forth, no problem. And that little 5.7 by 2.8, whatever it is, It would only knock off maybe 3/4 of them. It was like, wow, the difference in power. I was like, I am no longer interested in that round. But so I discovered this round, people who really know their guns, they're probably laughing at me right now, but I don't care. I discovered this round by accident, and I was like, holy moly, this is an impressive cartridge. It's I think I've heard it's about 1600 feet per second coming out of that of a 3-4 inch barrel. It's
yeah. Well, what's a 357 Magnum coming out? Something rather comparable,
right? And so you see, like we saw both you and I saw the video. It's a book test. The guy had a bunch of books, and he had a 9mm, a 357 Magnum, and he had the Tokarov, the Tokarov went. The 9mm went the shortest. The 357 was next, and the Tokarov went through like two more books than the 357 did. And I was, whoa! So I'm the ammunition. Now I was listening to some videos back in 2013 where they're saying the ammunition and prices are high, but actually I've seen them recently, and the ammo looks like the prices have come back down on those. Because I found a box of those of 50 for like $15.
So wow,
that's pretty good.
Is that Soviet made?
You should get up a little. I can hardly see. You're just you know, you're like that Mr. Whatever, that dude from Tim Allen show. You know, where he's talking over the fence. That's who you look like.
The neighbor.
The neighbor. Yeah, you don't want to be the neighbor. That guy. That guy died anyway. He's dead.
Did he?
Yeah, he died. He's dead.
What was his name?
His name is Deadstream. That's
Deadstream.
That's
nice.
Deadstream. It was Livestream, but now it's Deadstream. But after seeing a few videos, and theoretically, if I were to ever buy guns, and I happen to find one of these Tokarovs, from what I understand, and I'm not an expert on this, folks, so you guys can message me and tell me where I'm in error. From what I understand, the Polish ones are the ones that are really good. Romanians are kind of the junkie, but they're by junkie, they're still great. I mean, if I could find a Romanian one for $200, I would buy it. And you think, Dimitri and I, we were talking about this. What a stash and dash kind of gun to have on hand. Usually, you know, you think throwaway gun, bug out bag gun. You're not thinking the impressive kind of power that this gun has in it with that 7.62 by 2.5.
Yeah, that's if you're gonna bury a gun in the backyard, this would not be a bad one for that. For that price and the capability of that cartridge is tremendous. The question I have is, what kind of cartridges can you get for this thing? It's like, okay, so far everything I see is ball ammo. I mean, I know they're fans of this cartridge in Europe, and I believe CZ is still making this. Their guns chambered in this cartridge. Do they offer hollow points, hard casts? You know, what do they offer?
Well, let's ask the internet.
Okay.
We're going to do it now. We're going to go ahead and ask the internet.
Oh, that shows how well prepared we were for the show.
Well, we didn't prepare for the show. We just thought, hey, let's just do whatever this time. So we did. We knew we were going to talk about the 10 mil, but we didn't necessarily plan on talking about the Tokarev. So
going back to the 10 mil.
I'm actually not seeing anything that says hollow point.
Right. Oh, Let me talk about the 10 mil.
762. I'm sorry. 762 millimeter Tokarev jacketed hollow point.
Oh, lovely. How many grains? Is that an 80 grain?
Let's see. We're 85 grain. 85 grain.
So that thing is zipping.
And it's hollow. Wow. It's 19. It's $20 for 50. So it's about 40 cents per round. That's pretty decent.
Reasonable.
Yeah. Oh, I got to. I mean, not that I buy guns, but in my fantasy, I got to go get this. Got to get this. That's cheap, man. $200, $300 for a little surplus handgun? Dude. Military surplus handgun? Dude, that's the way to go. I get me a commie gun, baby. Get me. I don't have any commie guns. I don't have any commie guns in my life. I need a commie gun in my life.
You know, the thing that we kind of didn't touch upon with the 10 mil is why the FBI, you know, fielded the 10 mil. I mean, we've talked about this in the past in previous shows, but it's such a pivotal moment in the gun manufacturing industry that it's a big deal. Was it the shootout of 1983?
I think it's 86. Miami? I think it's 86.
Was it in 86? Okay, the 10 mil was introduced in 83. The shootout was in 86. The FBI adopted
the 40. The 40 is what came from that incident, not the 10 mil.
Well, the 10 mil was fielded by the FBI, and they couldn't handle it.
Right.
So then they did the 40 Smith & Wesson a couple years after that. But that shootout, you know, the FBI answered a question with the 10 millimeter that didn't exist. The perps in that shootout were using a Mini 14 against cops with 38 Specials 9 mils and a 12 gauge pump shotgun, and they were getting lit up. I mean, I don't remember the number of agents that were murdered that day, but it was enough where it changed the way that the FBI looked at shootouts. But what they did is they were trying to get a handgun to get into a shootout with a Mini 14 loaded with the 5.56. So they were going to a rifle fight with a handgun, and so they wanted a more powerful handgun. What they should have done is issued Mini 14s or ARs to their agents on the roads, on the streets, going after bad guys, you know, or at least go with full auto shotguns instead of the pumps, which need two hands to run the action.
And that turned out to be a problem for
It turned out to be a problem. In that shootout, it definitely turned out to be a problem because the one guy who had the shotgun, his one arm was wounded, and he was pumping the thing with one hand, holding it between his legs. And then, yeah, dude, if he had a semi-auto, he could have gotten on target. And
really, that shootout was really between one guy and six other guys, because the other guy that was with him, I think he only got one or two shots off.
He had a 357 Magnum, and all the agents were shooting 38 Special.
Yeah, 38 Specials, and they didn't even have. Well, I think when we did this show originally, I also pointed out that if the agents had plenty of ammo on hand, it probably would have been different in and of itself. They were all carrying light. They didn't have a lot of ammo with them that they were carrying.
Right.
And unfortunately, one of their really good shots, he dropped his glasses, couldn't find them. He could hardly see. He was taken out. He was out of the equation. So one of their really good shots couldn't even engage. That now there's nothing you can do. No caliber is going to help you on that front. But honestly, right. They came into that fight grossly under
ill-prepared.
Ill-prepared, right. I mean, and they could clearly see the guys. They knew the guy had a Mini 14. They had to know he had a Mini 14. I'm assuming they could see right in. They were.
That's a huge assumption. I don't know that they knew.
That's true. Maybe not. Maybe he had it under and then pulled it up.
Yeah. In any case, at any rate, they were looking for a handgun that would have made that shootout come out different. And I don't care what handgun you're shooting. You ain't going to go up against a rifle cartridge and a semi-auto.
Right.
With 30-round magazines, with a handgun, and come out on top, unless you're extraordinarily lucky.
The guy with the Mini 14, he was shot numerous times, and he was still able to fire. And he even suffered, you know, the wound that would eventually kill him. When it happened, he was still firing away before he died. When he hit somebody in his shoulder, he knocked that guy pretty much, just about knocked him out of commission.
He shot one guy in the hand, and it pretty much ripped up his hand and went
right,
to his shoulder and ripped his whole arm apart.
Right. That's what I'm thinking of. Yes, you got it right.
Yeah, and so... But
so one shot from the 5.56 tear you up.
But this is the point I constantly make with my buddies who are like, no, 9mm, it's all about placement. Dude, if you're in a shootout, good luck with your fucking placement. He got shot how many times with a 9mm and a 38 Special, which are comparable rounds?
Yeah, but
and
that
he didn't
also,
go down.
Yeah, but he got shot with 80s 9mm and 80s 38 Special.
Dude, they had plus P back then, too. But none of the agents chose to shoot hot rounds. They were all shooting light stuff. Because that's what they qualified with. They didn't want to shoot hot 357 Magnum rounds with, you know, solid cast bullets or, you know, name your round. They went in shooting light stuff like 9mm. And they got their asses handed to them. And that's why I would never suggest going into a shootout with 9mm. As a self-defense round... You know, if some guys
you're facing one unprofessional guy who's not hardcore. 9mm should do you just fine.
Right. Yeah, shot placement there will serve you well. If you're in a shootout, I'll speak for myself. If I'm in a shootout, I want 357 or 10mm. 40 cal is the minimum I'll go because I think 40 cal will do the job, especially if it's loaded hot. But 10mm is the way to go. And this 7.62x25, holy guacamole, that is a impressive cartridge. Just, I don't know how many pound foot of energy it has at the muzzle. I don't know what it does to ballistics gel. I don't know what kind of penetration it has.
Oh, yeah, we got more research to do on this puppy.
Oh, definitely. Oh, yeah. Because if this is what I think it is, then... Yeah, maybe I'll be looking for a CZ chambered in this stuff, in this thing. Not for myself. I'm just saying, theoretically, I would, you know, hypothetically, if I was into guns and if I was going to buy more firearms, you know, I might look at something like that.
Not that we buy firearms because...
Dude, after the boat accident on the Great
Lakes... I'm a little traumatized.
It was just a huge waste of money.
You don't want to go through that again. When you experience something like that, you're like, why bother? You know, I'm just going to, you know what I'm going to rely on? I'm going to rely on my good looks and charm to get me out of a bad situation.
Oh, good luck with that.
I'm probably going to die soon.
Look at that.
So I'm looking at the Wikipedia entry here. And let's see, it says bullet mass 5.5. grams, I'm assuming. Velocity 376.
Velocity or muzzle energy?
The muzzle energy, it goes from 390 joules, I guess. Is that joules or what is that? J, 390 J. All the way up to 715. and it goes from 1,200 feet per second to 1,700 feet per second.
Wow.
So 715, actually 715, that's, isn't that kind of a, that's approaching the 357 Magnum, isn't that?
Well, 357 is between 600 and 700.
Okay, so it's actually
put at energy at the Mosul.
So that's the so you got the 85 grain JHR is what's topping out at the highest. Actually, no, it's the 85 grain FMJ,
full metal jacket.
Yeah. So yeah. That's I don't see the pound feet thingy though. I don't.
Well, I'll look it up and we'll mention it in the next show, but. This is an impressive little round, and the fact that you can pick up one of these guns for $250, that's crazy.
That is insane. Like,
that's the kind, well, see, but that's the kind of gun you want to leave in your car.
Yeah.
Because if it's stolen, yeah,
no
biggie. I'll go get another one.
That's a good car gun. That's right. That's an excellent car gun.
And that cartridge, I'm thinking it'll go through windshields. I'm thinking it'll go through car doors. I'm thinking it'll be a much better gun than the 38 Special.
You know,
or
that round would have been a game changer at that
So you're saying
Miami shootout.
Soviet Iron Curtain cartridge would have served American agents, blue-blooded Americans, better than their 38 Special created here in America.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
I'm saying that. I have no allegiance to any nation or any people when it comes to guns.
Listen, I pledge allegiance to
the
round.
Pledge allegiance to the best gun.
To
That's
the round
what I do.
That will drop your ass hard.
That's, yeah, and yeah. If Martians made it, then I love Martians, yes. Okay? I don't care. I don't care if it's the Chinese, the Romanians, the Czechs, the Americans. I don't care. I can't even think of an English gun right now. Can you think of an English gun that you're like, oh, yeah. They're.
Oh, the English, they're wonderful.
I'm talking about a handgun, not. Yeah,
they're wonderful at copying other people's shit and calling it their own.
Oh, you love the English. Actually, if you really want to get on his
funny,
good side, fly the Union
English
Jack.
People. I love the English people. I detest their government.
I generally feel that way about most nations, so it's not a revolutionary thing. I mean, I can even say that about the Greeks. Well, actually, no, because I can't stand Greek people. They're really annoying. Ask me how I know.
But you know,
go ahead. Ask me how I know.
You know what makes up for it?
I'm just kidding.
When you come over to their house for the barbecues.
Oh, my. Oh, yeah.
Dude.
You know what? I'm just going to make a generalization based on some of the Greek friends that I have. Greeks know food, okay?
Oh,
Know food. If you have Greek friends in your life, your food taste will improve. And suddenly the crap you used to like, you won't like anymore. And you'll be like, oh, man, this isn't good enough anymore. It's just not going to cut it, you know?
Yeah. It's all in the herbs and spices.
Oh, it's all in the herbs and the spices.
Dude, oh, my God, on the video, you know what I just did? I just leaned over to...
You're out of the shot, dude. Come on, man. Get back in the shot.
Dude, I had a fart, and I leaned over, and it's all on video. That's embarrassing.
Don't do that, man. Don't do that.
That's embarrassing. I forget. I made this killer chickpea soup. It starts off like French onion. You know, you're caramelizing the onions with beef,
right,
and chicken, and pork stock, and... you're cooking it down and cooking it down, and you're adding cumin and oregano and lemon juice and cooking it down, and you toss in the chickpeas at the end that are pre-boiled, and you mix it up. Oh, man, and put in some roasted garlic.
You know what?
This is one of my favorite soups of all times.
Sounds great. You know what I had last night?
What'd you have?
I had Campbell's Chunky Pea Soup with the chunky potatoes and ham and...
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that.
It's so good. It's
so good.
Out of
a can. Out of a can.
Out of a can. Fight me! Yes, out of
a
can.
It was a chunky split pea?
Yeah.
It had potatoes in it?
It had potatoes and ham. And, oh, it was a very hearty, hearty. I don't know. They're not sponsors of us either, by the way. It's just, they're awesome. If you get a chance to try it.
I don't remember the last time I've had a canned soup.
Dude, it's awesome. I mean, it is. And you feel good afterwards. So I know it's, well, I don't know anything.
Loaded
usually if it's really, really processed, I get a reaction. I didn't get a reaction. So,
well, I don't get reactions anymore either, because when I want a soup, I make it.
Well, I work for a living, so I don't have time to slave over a hot stove like a good little house dad like you do.
Well, you know, the easy part is when you know how to cook, you can work and set the food and it cooks itself, and then you go back and check it like in an hour and turn the flame off. And it's called coordination, multitasking, you know.
Yeah, it's called wasting your time and your life when you could just open up a can of some Campbell's Chunky.
That's very American of you.
It is American of me. Although I will buy a commie gun, and I will like it, and I will embrace it, and I'll feel no guilt or shame.
You're going to embrace a commie gun.
I will. You got a problem with that?
Yeah, it just sounds a little gay.
I think we're at the end of the show here. I think we've reached the end.
Oh, thank God.
Once we get to the food conversation, ladies and gentlemen, this show has come to a grinding halt thanks to Dimitri's soup snobbery. That's right, soup snobbery. That's another thing when you have Greek friends. They're soup snobs. That's a fact.
Soup snobs?
Soup snobs. It's a fact. So we talked about the Tokarev. We talked about Donnie Skun.
I bet you he carries a 9mm.
Do you really think that Donnie carries a 9?
Yeah, I do.
I bet you he carries a gold-plated 1911 45 ACP. Yeah, it probably sings him to sleep. It's probably like one of those things.
So this gun is competing with Melania?
You mean competing for her affection, maybe? Okay, I went there. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I've said too much. And we're talking about the 10mm. And next week, we're going to... Maybe we'll give you, after we've looked more into the 7.62x25, maybe we'll talk a little bit more about that. Or maybe we'll talk about some new guns that have emerged. Have you looked at the SHOT Show videos? SHOT Show 17?
Yeah, I've seen some stuff from that.
Yeah, maybe we'll talk about those unless we don't find anything that really wows us. But
maybe next year we'll go to the SHOT Show.
Dude, as Full Auto, we should go as Full Auto.
Oh, man.
We should. They should, you know, even though we have like 500 listeners, they should still sponsor us, send us.
You have 500 relatives who listen to your show?
Yes. Yes, I do.
I have 500 relatives. None of them want to talk to me.
Well,
I'm grateful for that. Don't get me wrong.
That's a good thing. You really don't want to have 500 relatives that want to talk to you, because usually when they want to talk to you, it's, could you do me a favor?
No, it's usually, if you have 500 relatives and they all want to talk to you, that's because you hit the lottery.
Well, that's true. That's true.
And, oh, hey, you remember Uncle Gene here?
Yo, man, I always loved you.
Yeah.
Tommy, Paul.
Yeah. Yeah, we had some good times together, right?
Jimmy, Todd, you know, Paul.
I just got out of, you know, treatment, the methadone clinic.
Yeah, it's kind of rough, you know.
Yeah, it's kind of rough, and you know what I'm saying?
I'm not one to ask for things.
Yeah, but I need a hit real bad right now. Can you hook me up?
Yo, man, I wouldn't normally ask you, but it's special.
But since you won the lottery and all, and
yeah,
you know,
ain't no thin to you, you know, ain't no thin. This is like scratch for you, man. This ain't nothing. Matter of fact, I don't even have to be grateful for it because it's so nothing to you.
Yeah, you owe me, man.
Remember? Yo, man, give me my money!
Remember I gave you those Nihilators back in 1983?
And that's when you test your 10 mil out.
Remember those Nihilators? You got the cherry and I got the watermelon. You want the watermelon? You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, you know what I'm talking about. Don't
you know
even
I
like
always
love
that watermelon. You took it from me.
Wow. You're not allowed to talk about watermelon anymore. It's considered racist to even talk
about.
Oh,
it is?
Yeah, you can't even talk about watermelon.
Well, I enjoy watermelon. It's one of my favorite candy flavors.
It's out of bounds now.
Okay, let me remind you.
Oh, wait. No, Trump is president. You can talk about watermelon now.
No.
I think that's how it works.
No. How it works is I'm almost white, so I can like watermelon.
That's true. So you could like,
I can like anything I like.
No, you can't quite go there. You're almost white, so you're like No. I've already explained this to you as an almost white. How that works is this: you get none of the privilege that I enjoy as a white man, but you get all of the blame that I get as a white man. You're welcome.
True that.
Yeah, when it's time to collect, no. No, you ain't white. When it's time to pay, oh, you white. So why don't we sayonara people here, and you got a last remark or saying or one of your usual things. Go ahead, thing us. Oh man, I was ready to do it, and then you're like, add that last part. I'm like, oh man, nasastala naklia. What was it? Say it again.
Nasastekala.
Nasastekala.
Pedia.
Pedia. Nasastekala pedia.
Ke.
Kalinikta. Okay, great. What did I just say? Did I just say, please burn my underwear?
No, you said, be good, laddies.
Be good, laddies.
And good night.
And good night. And we'll see you next week. We'll see you here. We're on IPMNation.com. You could find us there. And again, you could find us on the Liberty Principle Facebook page, Tuesdays, 6 p.m. My name is Paul of New Shooting Self-Defense is Full Auto with my broken monkey, Dimitri. Wave bye-bye, Dimitri.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.